Hey, so today new video, going to show you how to create your own CD case mockups using a scanner and CD case that you can find everywhere. So I'm going to show you the whole process today, starting from the scanning and then editing layers on Photoshop. So all you need basically is a scanner, or I think you can probably do the same with a camera, with your own iPhone, iPad. I don't know what you guys are using, but all you need to do is to capture the picture of your CD case, and then a little bit of creativity, and then good knowledge of Photoshop. So here we go.
By the way, before the video starts, I wanted to say thank you to everyone who follows me on IG. You guys helped me reach 2K. It is crazy. So thank you guys. As I did when I reached 1K in August, I'm going to make a giveaway, but this time I will not open my shop for free for one day. That was pretty crazy, but that was pretty dumb because I lost a lot of money. So I'm going to select 5 people and I'm going to send them everything that I did today for free. So stay tuned on my IG if you want to know how to participate this giveaway, and let's go to work.
Okay, so before this video starts, I'm going to show you my setup, what I have, what I'll be using in this video. So this is my print scanner. This is an Epson Echo Tank, and it can scan for, if I remember correctly, 1,200 DPI, something like this. So we'll just turn it on.
Et j'appuie sur le bouton rouge.
Okay, so next I'm going to show you everything that I will be using for this video. And you will see that I have many stuff. So first of all, I'm going to show you the CD case that I have. I have this one that I used for this mockup. Then I have this one that I used for Stamina Project, and also this mockup. So I have, of course, a CD, a basic one. And I will be using this today. And also I have this CD case, which is pretty huge, pretty heavy. And I'm going to use this. And then I have this transparent plastic bag with a CD in it that I'm going to use too. And then I have wrapped paper for Christmas, for presents. I'm going to use this one because this one is ugly as fuck. Let's be real, this one is pretty ugly. This one is cool, so I'm going to use this one. And then I'm going to use these two bars from IKEA that I bought a few weeks ago. I don't know what these are actually. All of my shelves at home are good, so I don't think these are useful. So I'm going to use them. I just felt like if you are using these metallic bars as this or something like that, you can have some pretty futuristic thing going on. So this is what we are going to do today. Okay, so I totally forgot that I have many other things here, stuff like this. Actually, this is pretty good looking, and as you can see, I built this using only pieces from IKEA. And let me think. No, this will not be good. So this is the the setup that I've been using. I think it is pretty great actually. So this is just my CD, of course, the two metallic bars that I showed you earlier, and then these two things, I don't know what they are. This wheel, I think it is from my TV shelf. And then what I'm gonna do is take this CD case mockup and wrap it around this wrinkle paper. It's pretty hard to make it with one hand, but I think someone else did it first using aluminium. I don't remember who, but I'll put the link in the description. And then a pretty basic one, using the same CD as I'm gonna use for this mockup, and a plastic bag, transparent plastic bag. So let's put everything in a scanner. Thank you. Okay, so I just scanned it and I have a little problem here. As you can see, this is the result I get. And let me just resize it real quick. As you can see, the result is pretty neat here. So this is good looking. This is really perfect. You can see all of the details. But this is not. And this is due to the fact that this part of the metallic bar is on another level. So it gets a little bit blurry. So I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to scan everything one by one so I can have the better quality. And also for people who will say, why don't you close the door? It is because if I close the door, it won't change anything because this is not flat. So I'm gonna scan this and this, and after I'm gonna scan the two metallic bars.
Okay, so I'm done scanning everything. So this is the result I get. So this is the first one, which is a fail because this is so much blurry. And this one is blurry too, so I'm not gonna use them. And so after this, I scanned different pieces to add them on a Photoshop later. And these ones are pretty good. Good quality, good everything. Actually pretty good quality. So this is the CD case. This one was a fail too because as you can see, where is it? As you can see here, you have some different levels here. So this is everything that is going to be here is gonna get blurry. So what I did is scanning this with no CD in it, knowing that I can add the CD later. And this is the result. It is still a little bit blurry here, but I can edit this on Photoshop, so we'll be fine. And so this is the CD. I could use this one, but I wanted to use a different one. I don't know why. Probably because the result will not be the same. As you can see, the lighting here, the lightings here are not the same. And so yeah, I scanned the two pieces. I'm going to cut this part, add it here, and I'm going to keep this part, and I'm going to add everything and duplicate it to have both of them. This is the CD with a transparent plastic bag. And then this is the wrinkle paper that I used. And I'm going to edit everything to put this CD case on it. So here we go.
I'm going to show you how it's done.
Okay, my pitch pad like battle rappers that make albums with no outcome. Extra middleman, no mouth.
Okay, so we are back on Photoshop. The first thing you need to do is create a new document. I'm going to use 3000 pixels and 300 dpi RGB. And then I'm going to import my CD. I'm going to start with this. It is the easiest one. So let me just resize it to take... Now I'm going to duplicate this to save one. I'm going to rename my label on CD. And I'm going to get rid of everything but the CD and the transparent texture using the pen tool. Okay, so that was pretty quick. Then I'm going to define selection, use mask. And then I'm going to add a background on it. Rename this background. So here's the result now. What I gotta do is add some curves. So let me just change this real quick. I think this is good looking. Let me just see. Yep. And so now what I need to do is select the CD to edit everything on it. So a little tip, if you wanna select the CD, you can use the ruler and then just drag it. And this is what you'll get. Yep. So now I'm going to add another layer. Let's put it red with the mask. Let me just lower the opacity so I can see. Okay, so now I'm going to deselect this. I'm going to select this and click on my mask and Command I or Control I if you want on Windows. And this is the result. So now all I need to do is put this into multiply. That's it. So if you want to make some pretty simple mockups, that's all you have to do. So now everyone can change the color here, can put it blue. OK,
can put it green, can put it anything you want. Make sure to not do what I did. So I still have some issues here and I'm going to correct it right now. So what I'm gonna do is I think I'm gonna move this a little bit, and I think I'm gonna move this too. I think we are fine now. And then I'm going to invert selection and erase everything in the mask. Everything. And this is the result. I think it is fine, but I think I still have some issues around here. Oh, fuck. And so I'm going to correct this right now. Okay, so this is the final result, and now you have your first mockup ready. You can change the color here. You can put it green, blue. Okay, so I have this picture. This is from Denzel Curry and Kenny Beats. This is the cover for the collab project. Let me just resize it. And now all I have to do is create a new group called CD Design. And I'm gonna put I'm gonna put the mask on the group, which means that everything that you will put in the group will have the shape of the CD. And you have your design.
Okay.
That was the easiest one. Also, you can still change the curves, everything you need. But this is the first that I'm gonna be using. And now we're going to work on the two others. Okay, so now part two, second mockup that I'm gonna make. So same settings, same background. I'm always using black background because I think it's beautiful. So I'm going to import everything. Okay, so now that everything is in Photoshop, I'm not going to resize it now because these three documents are the same size and I don't wanna waste it. So let me just show you real quick what I mean by this. First of all, I'm going to select the CD and then I'm going to select this. Let me just hide everything. Let me just change the background to green. Okay, this is fine. This is acceptable. And then same one here. Actually, I think I can do it by myself without using rulers. Okay, so now I'm going to select the CD case. So let me just get rid of it. There. I'm going to select my CD case. Okay, so here's the result. And now if I add my CD on it, you can see that this is the same size. And this is what I meant when I said that I didn't want to resize it now. And now I need to do the most difficult one, and this is the wrinkled paper that I used, and I'm going to show you a little tip on it. As you can see, the borders are pretty blurry and this is not what I want, so I'm going to cut it and make it realistic. So let me just start over here, and instead of doing this and this, I'm gonna cut right into it, doing stuff like that, and this will be realistic. Yes. So I have my three elements, and now what I need to do is put it in places. So I had first my CD case, then my CD, and then the wrinkled paper on top of it. So here's what I'm going to do. So I'm going to put the CD case behind it, and then the CD, and then the wrinkle paper. I'm going to align it. I think it was something like that. And I'm going to select this. Okay, so now that I have everything, as you can see, it fits well. So now I need to erase this. So this is gonna take a little bit of time, I guess. Thank you. Okay, so now I need to invert my selection to the mask, and this is what I get. And let me just place it good, something like that. Yes. And now I can change my CD. So what I'm going to do is group, I'm going to call it CD, and then I'm going to select this. I'm going to make a color mask, put it into multiply, and I'm going to deselect this shape and erase everything. Okay, so now I can still change my CD color here. Okay, so now I can just take this image and put it in. I need to put the mask on the group. And now I have my stuff.
It was at this moment that he knew. He fucked up.
Oh, fuck. I'm so dumb. Holy shit. I just realized that my wig on paper was scanned using black and white setting, so this is not in color. Okay, so I have a problem here. I'm pretty dumb, but when I scanned my wrinkle paper, I forgot to turn my scan settings to colors, so I have it in black and white.
Are you fucking dumb? Are you fucking dumb?
And this is not the result I wanted, so now I'm trying to understand what can I do.
2,000 years later.
Okay, so we are finally back. After realizing that I scanned my wrinkle paper in black and white, that was the result. But this is not what I wanted, because I wanted to keep them colors. I wanted to keep these colors. So I had to rescan it and edit everything I did with the paper. And this is the result that I have now. As I did earlier with the first mockup, I can still change the CD color here with the same technique. So as long as your group named CD here have the mask of the CD, you can place anything you want in it. So I placed an image. I put the image into multiply to keep the CDR Sony and compact disc recordable. So now what I want to do is add a little bit of shadow to this. So I'm going to drop shadow, put it to multiply, not a big size actually, I think it's more of a distance, so like, yeah, something like that. Then what I can do is play with the vibrance of my paper, put it more colorful. So there's something you can do if you want to achieve this result, like if you want to change the paper color. It is called gradient map, and you can find it right here. This is this icon, and what it does is, like, I'm gonna show you a quick example of what I did here. As you can see right now, the background is blue and the leaves are green and the flowers are red.
Roses are reds, violets are blue. God made me pretty. What happened to you?
Now what happens if I add a gradient? Let me put like this gradient. I'm gonna put it on top of it and let's say color. As you can see, it will take the color from the gradient, and like right here the leaf is purple, right here it is yellow. So this is not what we're looking for here, and a quick way to achieve it is using gradient map. And what you can do is just click on this icon, and I have many gradient maps because I use them a lot. And what it does is it takes the colors that you have on your layer, on your picture, on anything, and it will replace it with other colors. As you can see here, if I change, like, let's say I'm gonna change green. So everything that is green here has been selected from previous colors. And if I put it blue, everything will be blue. And so this is how you achieve this kind of result. I just took like the two colors that I've seen on it, and this is the gradient that I used.
Boredom, 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 bo
Okay, now the third one. So I just added my logo on it. I erased the IKEA thing, and let me just put it back to this. And so I have all of my images, all of my pictures. I have my wheel, I have my CD, and I have these two metallic bars that I scanned earlier. I just erased the IKEA logo and the name of it, Besta. Now what I need to do is take this part and this part and this one, because these three are pretty good looking. They are not blur or anything. They are pretty sharp. And then I'm going to merge them all to make it look like it is only one object, and then I'm going to duplicate it to put it on the other way. The final result should look like this. This is the result that I'm looking for. Something like this. Pretty futuristic and pretty good. So first thing I need to do is select this part, and then I'm going to select the other one.
Six and a half hours later. Day two.
A quick tip on selecting this is, now that I selected it, if I add a mask on it, I won't be able to see anything around it. So what I do is create a new layer that I'm going to call first selection, and I'm gonna just add the color on it. So later I can still, using command and click, keep my shape.
20 minutes later.
Okay, so I have my three selections here. This one I can just add the mask, and then I'm going to select this and this and invert it. So I should have everything. Yes. So what you need to do now is rasterize your layer. Apply the mask on it, and then I'm going to select this, cut, and paste. Okay, and now I just need to put it on top of it as it was, as if it was only one object. So I think I'll do something like this. What happens now? Yes, I think it is good. Maybe not here. I'm just gonna get rid of this a little bit. Just like that. And then I think we're fine. Yes. Let me just... Okay, so now I have to do the same thing here. And I'm going to move it a little bit. And I think we are fine now. Let me just check quick. Yep. Okay, so now the second part will be pretty easy. I just have to select the wheel and the CD, and using the same technique as I told you a few minutes ago. So, like this. Okay, so now I have all of my elements. I just need to rasterize it and apply the mask and separate these two objects. So now I have my CD, my wheel, and my metal bar. And what I need to do also, I need to get rid of this. Okay, so now I have my three objects. So I have my wheel, CD, and I duplicated metal bar. I'm gonna call this one two. So this is the result that I need. Okay, so now I need to put it in the way that will look like this. So what I'm gonna do is place the wheel on top of the CD layer. Just put it in the center, like this. And let me just rotate the wheel, pick my wheel, because I want the text to be linear. Okay, and now the metal bar, I think what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna get rid of everything here. Okay, so I just got rid of one sticker using this tool. And now I need to put everything on top of it. Let me just rotate this to make it look straight. Yep. And I'm gonna call this metal bar up and metal bar down. Oh, also, what I would like to do is sent to them. And what I would like to do is probably get the CD in this area, like on top of it here. Okay, so now that I have this, I want to get the CD on top of the bottom metal bar. So what I'm gonna do is just select this, select my CD, put a mask, invert it. Actually not this one, I think. Alright, so I had to eat because it is pretty late here in France, and so this is the result I get for the third mockup. And what I was thinking about is probably duplicate this and put it in the same place as the sticker one, and then take these two layers, duplicate them and rotate to have many shapes. I'm thinking something like this maybe. Once again, horizontal symmetry, and maybe I should get rid of this and this and put this one on top of everything, and this will be pretty good, I guess. Then I'm going to take every metal bar including the sticker, name this group metal bars, and I'm gonna add a color layer. Let's put it blue. Maybe green, I think. Some lime could be good, maybe even this, and then put this layer in color mode. So this is the effect. Of course I'm going to get rid of the sticker place in the mask, so I just have to get rid of this. So this is the outcome that I get now. What I can do is rename this on change metal color, and I still have my CD, and I will put the cover on the CD. So I'm gonna have to find a good picture album cover. What can I get? I think I'm gonna get this title creator, and so I'm gonna add the picture here. Let me just hide the metal bars so you guys can see better. Center this, and then I'm going to make a group, change CD artwork, and I'm gonna add, so I need this, and I don't need this. Bam, there you go. I think I'll put it into multiply. And what I will do is I'm gonna duplicate my CD layer and play with the curves so I can have something darker, and now I can see the text on it. As you can see, this is what I had before and this is what I get now. So I'm gonna rename this your image here. And then all you have to do is just drop your image. So I'm gonna copy this, copy, paste in this group, and this will automatically add the mask on it. So you don't have to do anything because it is in the group. And then you can still change the metal bars. And also, let's say you want to have like three colors for your metal bars. All you have to do, so let me just duplicate this and hide these two so I can still keep them. Alright, so I'm gonna take these two, I'm going to put them on some other group, and about your one, and then I'm gonna take maybe these two and put them on another group, metal bar 02. And all you have to do now is just the same way I did first. So add a color layer, put it here on color mode, and do the same for this. Let's say this one will be green, and same for this, and I'm gonna put this one yellow and this one blue, Now you can see that you have this effect and you don't want this effect, and this is due to the fact that the red bars are on top of it, so you need to put them on top. And that's it, that's all you have to do. And you still have to get rid of the place where the sticker is, so I'm gonna just copy this and there you go. Now you know how to make three cool CD Case mockups with stuff that you have at home.
So as I mentioned in the beginning of my video, I'm doing a giveaway, and these three mockups that I made today are going to be in the giveaway. So if you guys want to earn them or get them for free, all you have to do is go on my IG, like and comment the post about this video, about these three mockups, and I will pick five of you and send you guys the link to download this. Alright, so I hope you enjoyed the video, I hope you liked it, and I hope that you will create good content with this, and see you guys later. Well, you always in the mood, baby, I